How's it going, guys? Today we're going to look at colliding spheres. And we're going to look at the code behind spheres. Now, spheres are one of the easiest ways to do collisions in 3D because the rotation doesn't matter. When you use squares or rectangles or capsules, the rotations of them matter and it gets a lot more complicated. But if you're just using spheres, it's very simple. So I just want to show you that and show you a code example so that you know how to use it. And it works the same in 2D. So all you really need for your collider sphere is a center and a radius. And if it moves, all you have to move is the center, which is just a point. GLM Vec3, in case you don't know, is just three floats in this case, an X, Y, and Z in 3D space. So what we have here is just a very basic structure in C++, and that's what we're going to be working with. So as you can see here, if we instantiate a new collider sphere, all we need is a location and a radius, and that's it. So let's look at the instantiation here. So if you give it a location and a radius, it just sets those. And if you don't give it anything, we're just assuming 0 for the center, centered at 0, 0, 0, X, Y, Z. And the radius of 1. That's just how I have it in my code. Let's move on to the handling of it. So now that you know what a collider sphere consists of, just a center and a radius, how do you actually handle it? So that's what we're going to look at next. So I've got this function here that returns a boolean, and the function is called sphere versus sphere, and it takes a pointer to a sphere and a pointer to another sphere. And let's go look at the instantiation of that. We'll also look at this point one, this point versus sphere, which takes just a point and a sphere. But mainly we're looking at sphere versus sphere. So in the sphere versus sphere, so you have to pass it in two spheres, of course, naturally. So we have the main one and the other one. And we're doing this by const pointers just to make sure they're not changed. And a pointer is a very small piece of memory, so that way we don't have to move around a whole lot of things. We could do it by reference, but it would be essentially about the same as a pointer. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do in our code, I guess actually before I move on, the point of it being a pointer here is so that we can check if it's null. If it were a reference, the null check would be a little different. So we don't ever want these to be null. So we have this initial check just to make sure neither are null. Now this is kind of verbose code. It could be written, simplified, and you don't have to put equal equal. I could put like if not sphere or not other, get into a little C++ stuff there. But that is also legal to see if they don't exist. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to get the distance from the two center points. And we can do it in this method. This, I think, is about the fastest way you can do it math-wise. And we're using multiply here because it is faster than divide in general. So all we do is we get the center of one x minus the center of the other x, and we times it by itself again, center of one x minus the center of the other. So we just times those together. And we do the same for the y and the z, and we add those all together, and then we square root the whole thing, and that gives us the distance of the center points. And then all we do here at the end is we want to return a boolean of true or false, true if it collides, false if it does not. So it's the distance. If the distance is less than the sphere radius plus the other sphere radius, then it collides. If it's greater than, then they're not colliding, and it's that simple. So that's all we do. The point is just about the same. We just don't have to mess with the radius of both of them. So you get the distance between the point and the center. And then you check if that's less than just the sphere radius. So point versus sphere and sphere versus sphere are probably the simplest colliders just because you don't have to think about rotations at all. So when you get into those other ones, that's where it gets complicated. And for now, in my engine that I've been writing, I'm just using spheres because they're simple to write. And well, the other ones are simple if you're not doing rotations. Rotations is where it gets complicated. So let's look at an example of the sphere versus sphere. I have been building this little asteroid thing with this code, and in here I have a check collide function that runs every loop or every update. And all it really does is it calls sphere versus sphere, and it passes in two spheres. One of them is our laser, and the other one is our asteroid. Go, in this instance, is my little acronym for game object, so everything with the Go is a game object. So we get the collider sphere of our laser, we get the collider sphere of our asteroid, which goes off the edge here. And if it returns true from this whole if statement, I know it looks weird because it's multi-line, but it's just so long that I split it up. So if this returns true, then it says first asteroid hit. And same, we do the second one too. We just have a check for each of these asteroids, basically, against the laser. And that's all it does. So let's go ahead and run this. Now note that I'm just using a CL for now. I don't have them actually exploding or anything. That's something I'm doing later. So yeah, some debug info there. But if I shoot my laser, you see it passes through this one. It says first asteroid hit. It actually spams it a bunch of times because it registers a whole bunch of times before it passes through. It doesn't break, so to speak, in code. And same with the second one. And I've just got a tiny little sphere on my laser, and I've got spheres about the size of these wrapped around those. So that's just to confirm that it works. Now what I should do is, on the first detection of a hit, I should like despawn my laser and make a little effect happen, but instead it just keeps going because I just don't have anything in the code to say that. But that's just to show you that the sphere versus sphere works in this manner. Hope you enjoy this episode about collider spheres, and maybe it'll help you out if you're trying to figure them out. I love them because they're just so simple to work with, and just not having to deal with rotations is super nice. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you in the next episode. Peace out, everyone. And also, as a last little note here, this is actually not for my normal viewers. Someone was trying to get a hold of me from a company, and I can't email you back because your servers are rejecting my emails. There's not really anything I can do about that, but Yulia, if you wish to continue working with me, unblock my emails, or I don't know, get a hold of me some other way. Maybe give me a link to a Discord or something. I'm not sure what else to tell you. I've tried to email you 3-4 different times. I'd like to work with you. I don't want you to think I'm ghosting you, but I can't help that your server is rejecting my emails.